Hello, good afternoon students. Jai Sanskar. Now we reach the third point of our lesson number 13, Fun with the Magnet. In our last two previous videos, we have learned that what are the types of the magnet and how it works and what are the poles. So now in our next video, that is 13.3, we are going to learn about the finding directions. Let's read and understand the point. Magnet were known to the people from the ancient time. Many properties of a magnet were known to them. You might have read many interesting stories about the uses of magnet. One of such a story is about the emperor of in China named Huang Ti. It is said that he had a chariot with a statue of a lady that rotated in any direction. It had an extended arm as if it was showing the way. See, magnet is a concept of early times. Even in early times, people are using magnet for so many things, and particularly to show the or to find out the directions. Similarly, there is an example over here, that is a story over here, you can say that, and that is about the king of the China, and the name of the king of the China is Huang Ti. And it is said that it has a chariot with the lady, the statue of lady. You can see here, statue of lady. And what was about the special about this lady? It is made up of magnetic compass. And sorry, made up of magnetic power. How it is worked? It just show a direction by extending her hand. If it is showing. The statue had an interesting property. It would rest in such a position that extended arm always pointed towards the south. See, what is the specification about this statue of lady? It will always come to the rest into the south direction. Whenever it goes, it always goes to rotate, and when it comes to the rest, it is always been the south direction. So from this south direction, you can definitely decide the other direction, like east, west and north. The emperor was able to locate the directions when he went to new place on the chariot. So whenever the emperor, that is a king, goes to any place, he doesn't need to be worried about the direction in which it is going on. He just accurately see the map and then decide the directions with the help of this statue of a lady. Let us make such a direction finder for ourselves. So let's we also do the same. How do we make a direction finder? To understand this better, we need to perform an activity. Activity 5. Take a bar magnet, put a mark on one end of its ends and identification. Now tie a thread the middle of the magnet so that suspended it from a wooden stand, and make sure that the magnet can rotate freely. Let it come to rest. Mark 2 points on the ground to show the position of the ends of the magnet when it comes to rest. See, it is very easy. Take a wooden stand like this, then tie a magnet with a thread and let it be freely rotated. And also mark N and S pole in the magnet. And when it comes to the rest, to the south direction, it means it's south. So it is like that. Now turn the page. Draw a line joining to the two points. This line shows the direction in which the magnet was pointing in its position to the rest. So you need to draw a line towards the poles. It will help you to show that in which direction the magnet comes to the rest. Now rotate the magnet by gently pushing one end into any direction and let it come to the rest again. Mark the position of the two ends of the position of rest. Does the magnet now point in any different directions? No. What you need to do, you need to rotate by just giving slight pull to the magnet and it will just start it rotating. And when it comes to the rest, you need to definitely verify this again, that first position remains the same at the second time. Means if it shows the north direction, then again when you rotate, make it rotation, again it shows the north direction. If it is yes, then it means that this is always comes to the rest into the north direction or a south direction. Rotate the magnet in another direction and not the final direction in which it comes to the rest. Do you find that the magnet always comes to the rest in the same direction? Yes, it is always come to the rest into the same direction. Now you can guess the mystery behind the statue in the emperor's chariot. So now you definitely get the idea that why it is always come to the rest into the north, the south directions. Repeat this activity with an iron bar and a plastic or a wooden scale instead of a bar magnet. Do not use a light object for activity and avoid doing it where there are currents or air. Do the other materials also always come to the rest in the same directions. See, now what you need to do, you need to repeat this activity, but you need to be careful that this activity should not be performed whenever the air is more, because it cannot make the magnet to comes to the rest and the magnet continuously rotating. We find that the freely suspended bar magnet always comes to the rest into the particular direction, which is north or south direction. See, the if we mark the south directions only, then we can say that it always comes to the rest into the south direction. If we mark it to the north, then it comes to the rest into the north direction. So this way you can identify by marking the direction on the bar magnet and you make it rotate freely. Whenever it comes to the rest into the particular direction, that will be the direction of the earth. Use the directions of the rising sun in the morning to find out through the directions towards the east. One more, the best watch of the whole world is always been sun. Sun always rises from the east and always set into the west. So sun can be the best watch. The best directions shower. If you stand facing east, your left will be north. Suppose that I am facing east, then my north means this direction can be east. North. If I am standing here by facing east direction, then this direction left side will be north and the right side will be south, and my back side is always been west direction. If only I am facing the east direction. Using the sun for finding directions may not be very exact, but it will help to make out the direction north from the south or on your line. Using this, you can figure out which end of a bar magnet pointing to the north and which pointing to the south. See, it is not always said that this is the sun is accurate, but yes, you can definitely find the north and south directions by figure out the proper way. The end of the bar magnet that point towards the north is called north seeking end and the north pole of a magnet. The other end of the point towards the south is called south seeking end and the south pole of a magnet. All the magnets have two poles, whatever their shape may be. Usually the north N and the south S pole are marked on the magnet. See, whether it is any direction, rotation of the magnet in any direction, but it always shows the two directions, that is north and south. So we should need to mark it as a N to the north direction and S to the south direction. This property of a magnet is very useful for us. For countries, travelers have been making use of the properties of a magnet to find out a direction. It is said that the olden days, the travelers used to find a direction by suspending the natural magnet with a thread which they always carried with them. It is said that it is very useful for the travelers, for the person who's like to go to the different places and they doesn't have idea about the location, that which direction is that. So they use the natural, it is said means evi baat karvama avti ke they use the natural magnet to locate the directions. Later on, the device was developed based on the property of a magnet. It is known as the compass. See, ena pachi compass namna je, see, this is a compass. Direction finder ni shodh thai, it is found out. Then we use, even we use today the compass as a find the directions. A compass is usually a box, a small box with a glass cover on it. A magnetized needle is pivoted inside the box. See, a magnetized needle, this is a magnet, it's a kind of a magnet around which the box is given. That is a small box which shows a direction. The compass also, which can rotate freely. The compass also has a dial with a direction marked on it. The compass is kept at the place where we wish to know the direction. See, first, how we use this compass to find the direction. We need to take this compass and put it down, and it just rotate into the always and always north or south direction. So this way you can find the direction. The needle indicates the north-south direction when it comes to the rest. The compass is then rotated until the north and south marked on the dial are the two end of the needle. To identify the north pole of a magnetic needle is usually painted in the different colors. See, usually it is painted in a different colors when it shows the north or south direction or the direction that is to be found it. So what do you learn from this? You learn from this that to find out the directions, the sun, the compass and the other measure is very useful. So here the 13.3 is over.